Moin, this is Timo, I work for KDAB. What do you think? What do all these applications have in common? Well, they all have a flexible way of organizing the layout of the UI. What you see here is called a docking system. So, what is a docking system or dock widgets? Dock widgets are windows that the user can embed into the main window. He can move them around to achieve any layout he wants by mouse dragging. Dock widgets can be layouted side by side or tapped in a group. They can also be detached and become a top-level window. Dock widgets allow to display windows in an organized way instead of having them floating around and stacked on top of each other. In big applications with many features, it's difficult to create a widget layout that satisfies every user. Different users have different needs. The best way to solve this is let the user himself rearrange the layout as he pleases. In fact, even a single user might have different needs, depending on what he's working on. Custom layouts can also be saved and loaded with just what's needed. Let's take a look at solutions for Qt applications. QDockWidgets is included in Qt. It's missing many features, though present in other well-known non-Qt docking libraries like MFC. Qt company has acknowledged QDockWidget is done and won't be receiving any major additions. KDAB also sees contributing to it. So a new solution was needed, and here KDDockWidgets comes into play. KDDockWidgets was created by Sérgio from KDAB. It was developed to meet clients' criteria who were looking for modern docking features. KDDockWidgets is a lot easier to extend and adapt to clients' application and not the other way around. Sérgio was working on a client's project using QDockWidget, but couldn't make it do what was needed. His research was promising, and in addition to help his project and keep his mind sane, it was picked up as R&D and eventually became KDDockWidgets. If you want to play around with the WebAssembly demo you just saw, you can use the link down below or in the descriptions. Now let's see how to build and install KDDockWidgets. Assuming you haven't done it yet, you just need to cmake-g ninja and pass it your preferred installation folder, and then you can build and install it as usual with ninja and ninja install. The next step would be to set up your project to find and use KDDockWidgets. The two key moments here are the find package cmake command that will look for KDDockWidgets in your usual cmake module path. Then you simply link your application against KDDockWidgets with target link libraries, which takes care of setting the include and link path for you too. Instead of creating a Qt main window, as you were used to, you now create a KDDockWidgets main window. Instead of creating QDockWidget as before, you now create KDDockWidgets DockWidget. KDDockWidgets DockWidget provides the method setWidget to host or wrap your own widget, and KDDockWidgets main window provides the API to dock them. So, what's new in KDDockWidgets? It is, as far as we know, the only docking framework to support Wayland. This is important since many Linux distros are moving away from X11 to Wayland, and many applications will fail to work correctly if they are currently using QDockWidgets. KDDockWidgets is tested on both Qt 5.15 and Qt 6. Experimental support for Qt Quick is added, and it's already being used by the upcoming version of MuseScore. WebAssembly support is added. This allows you to use KDDockWidgets in applications that run in your browser. Also, MDI layout support is added. So, what's so cool about KDDockWidgets? It supports both traditional Qt widgets and Qt Quick. It allows every internal widget to be derived by the developer so he can fine-tune the behavior. It has feature parity with MFC Visual Studio docking, including Visual Studio style drop indicators. This makes porting from MFC to Qt straightforward. It's possible to create custom-made drop indicator systems, as not everyone wants the Visual Studio drop indicators. It's stable and clean code. 200 tests make regression unlikely. KDDockWidgets is available under two licensing models, commercial license and GPL. For further information, contact us via info@kdab.com or visit the link shown below or in the descriptions. Thanks for your attention. I hope this has been of some use to you. See you on the next video.
A major advantage of this is maintaining a similar look and feel across these fundamentally different but related tools. In the past, we had built our own docking system, but it was majorly limited. Recently, we decided to switch to using KDDockWidgets from KDAB. This powerful docking system provides all of the docking primitives that we need in order to allow our users to customize their layouts as they please. Being able to leverage a well-tested, robust, and industrial-strength docking system that is maintained by the expert Qt developers at KDAB has been a tremendous boon for us and our users.